Hey guys, Luke here, and we got another video. I think this is episode 16 of my I was gonna say Bulldogs crewmate. It's not Bulldogs crewmate. It's the Dream Team. Now we're running with we're running with the same lineup as we had last time. We're taking on the Wigan Warriors this time, the 2013/14. I don't know. Is it 14? No, we'll just go 2013 Super League champions. I think they also won Challenge Cup. So basically, I don't know if this is the right explanation, because I don't really know too much about the Challenge Cup, but I suppose it's kind of like the FA Cup of the Super League. Hello, so for NRL people, like if we had another knockout competition as well as the NRL going on, I don't know, maybe that's something we should look to introduce. I mean, I wouldn't mind it. We could throw in some like lower teams, maybe like the FA Cup thing that the soccer is doing, because I think that's been kind of cool. Be interesting to see just the level of difference between like the group, for example, group 16 or something like that, their champions, compared to like the Roosters. Sounds kind of stupid, but I think you follow what I mean. So there's the lineups. Now I noticed that like it seemed kind of weird. Like a lot of Australians would just judge, like including myself. Like we've only really had like one way to judge Wigan, and we haven't really judged it off this side. Now let's be honest, the side that we saw in Australia was nowhere near the side that they are here. I mean, it might be debatable for some English people, but let's be honest, they might be better or might be worse. I don't know, but like you take out from their side that played the Roosters, that, you know, weren't flogged, I don't think. I mean, I don't feel that they were ever going to win, but, you know, they had, they lost Sam Tompkins. You can say that they got Matt Bowen, but at the time, like, he looked fat and unfit. Like, this, like really, I remember seeing Matt Bowen being like, Jesus Christ, he's let himself go. He doesn't really care about Super League that much. I think now he might have become alright, but I don't even think he set the world on fire at Super League when he first started. So if you can leave in the comments someone like Super League people, that'd be great to sort of, you know, am I right in saying that? Also, I think I saw Lee Mossop play for them. Lee Mossop, the guy's at the Parramatta Eels now. You know, he's been struck down with injury. He wouldn't have played anyways, I don't think, because of injuries, but, you know, he was in that side. Pat Richards was like their like leading point scorer or something, I think, like every year. Like, he's the goal kicker, everything, so he's a big person to replace there. Saw Charnley, I was pretty impressed with Charnley, to be honest, when he played. It's hard to remember too much because, you know, it was so long ago. But Roosters, I think Roosters, they were good. Especially, like, after that game, it was going, oh, Roosters, they're going to, like, blitz at home. And then they opened the season so shit after that. We have B-Mores getting a try here. Putting us up 4-0 against Wigan. So we'll keep the goal. Yeah, but I don't know whether were Wigan, are they good? Like Roosters smashed them, or they didn't smash them. That they won pretty convincingly. We'll say that. More than a thrashing, because when I say convincingly, it's more like I don't feel like they're ever going to lose. I think Wigan had a little comeback, but it was pretty much Roosters were going to win. Ball and all tackle there. Where was I going with this? Uh-oh. Alright, turned out alright. Come on, Tompkins, what are you doing? So, I was going, trying to get over the fact... I actually forgot what I was going to say. Too many distractions. Too many line breaks here while I'm trying to, talk. Yeah, so I was saying, like, with the Roosters, like, we all thought they were going to come out and blitz it after beating Wigan, like, they're Super League champions, but does that show the quality of Super League? Like, who knows? But like I said, like, they're missing a fair few players. I'm sure there probably would have been some even more, like, people leaving to other Super League clubs, not just, you know, the Richards and Tompkins. Be a bit naive to think that, you know, only the players in the NRL are good. And I think Tompkins has done a pretty good job this year. Pat Richards came back and showed that he's still a good player. He was one of the better wingers in the comp. Nearly got a spot in New South Wales. I mean, it was due to injuries and stuff. But, you know, he nearly got there. Good on to him. He showed, like, he's sort of like... I don't know, he's created... What I find is really cool is almost before kickoffs were just something that you just did, Smith. Except for maybe like if you're behind with like 5 minutes to go and you get a chance and you just throw up a short kick. And that was it. That's about all it got to with experimenting. And I think with Pat Richards, and it seems kind of weird because he's been doing that for a little while with in the Super League, but I guess not many people really took notice of it. But he's coming to the NRL. I remember he terrorised Ben Barber one night. Ben Barber's a fullback, mind you, like, or the Broncos in particular. And yeah, his kickoffs are just so, like, they're so strange, like. Sometimes they go like a little short, and it's hard to judge because sometimes he might belt it, and next minute he just floats it up like halfway. So yeah, it's hard for teams to defend against, and I've seen so many people try to replicate it, but none of them have been able to like even pull it off half decently. And I suppose he doesn't want people to start doing that. That's like his thing. I wouldn't want to start giving out my secrets to other playmakers, or not other playmakers, to other goal kickers. Especially, like, you know, that makes you worthwhile. That can earn you, like, more money in your contract, all that sort of stuff. Just things like that. Might not seem like much, but I'm sure, like, Pat Richards, like, to him, it's a lot more.
And he's run into a good tackle there.
Now, just about up to half time. Remember to drop a like and subscribe to the channel and all that sort of stuff too. I've got to remember to start doing that a little bit more. Sonny Bill. Oh, what a hit.
Oh,
come on, Hainsey. Tompkins is chasing. And he tackles him. How the hell did you catch Jared Hayne? No way, dude. Tompkins isn't even good on this game. Well, like, start off with. Let me put that straight, like, in career mode. He's awesome, but that's like his attributes get better for a little while. And I know I've got Tompkins on here, but I did like did his stats up more accurately.
Some super tackles from both.
Wait, we should put some subs on. That might be a good idea. James Graham just doesn't do it for me on this game. I don't know why. Oh, sorry. He is good. Like I said, in career mode, he's really good, but it just in this side, it doesn't really fit in. So it's at the Bulldogs, I'm like utilising him all the time. Wearing this, I'm just sort of, you know, passing him to him every now and again.
Halted in that tackle.
Now, at the time, like, recording, the finals,
with momentum, I think now.
Roosters and Cowboys are playing tonight, and then tomorrow night it's
Thurston.
Tomorrow night, it's Bulldogs and Manly.
No respect. And we get the ball back.
I was trying to pass it out there, but it probably would have went forward, so probably a good thing we didn't. Yeah, so I'm thinking maybe I can do, like, we can play the top four people. I think that'd be kind of cool. Like, all the top four. Or we can make, like, a best-of team from the final four remaining sides. I mean, obviously, it's all going to be up to debate on who's actually, like, the best players. But, you know, leave in the comments, suggest some teams. And I said that the last episode, but, you know, I record these all at one go, so I wouldn't have been able to read them as of yet, because it's not uploaded. Going to pass it to Sonny Bill, SBW, so he can do everything. And it's a decent kick, I suppose. There wasn't too much in it. Wish there's more variety of kicks you do. There's so many things I wish they could fix in this game. Or, not fix it. I just want a new one to come out. And you bet your ass, like, if a new one comes out, I will be. And I'm still doing YouTube. Even, I'll bring back YouTube even if I'm not doing it for a new game. And I'll be doing career mode, everything. It's just, it's so hard to get into this game now because, like, you got FIFA 15 and all that. See the quality between games. I know it's hard to judge, but, like, all those new games coming out, I'm here playing, like, a game that came out in 2012. I don't know, and it's nearly 2015.
Smith runs
get it to Thurston. Ooh, it's not good enough there.
Strong runs.
Do it, Hainsey.
Tackles, tit for tat right.
Picks it up.
And they've managed to get to the ball.
So it's six to go. Pretty debatable. See, just things like that. Tompkins, those little things just
puts in the grubber.
Crap, that sucked. Sucked ass. It's Tompkins' fault. Super League sucks. Just kidding. I'm just kidding. No need to get your knickers in a knot. Yeah, so, any, like, Australian fans here, I'd like to hear your thoughts on Super League as a whole. Like, and also, with your opinion, say, like, whether you watch it or not. Because I never really understand people who give an opinion on Super League, but then say, oh, well, I've never watched it. And it's like, well, how can you give an opinion? How can you give an opinion, like, how can you say for sure that the NRL is so much better when you've never watched it? Is it just because it's Australian, you just assume? Well, I suppose you think A-League's better than Premier League.
Over the halfway line, contained by the defence.
I don't know, I'm probably just spewing brilliant shit right now. The defence tonight has been exceptional. I thought it's worth first mentioning.
So when the tackle does the job, Smith.
I think I'm kind of, I can kind of give, like, I'm not really that qualified to do it because I haven't watched too many, but on Eurosport, I watched a fair few games. I mean, I haven't really watched any of the shitty teams. That's probably where the things. Oh shit. Thank God for that. I think you heard me say, oh shit. So we're going to go Thurston to Tompkins, see if we can split them through the middle here. And we just got a little bit too late. So we could have run around the defence there. I just pressed the sprint too early. Oops. Good to have Matt Scott coming off the bench. Just, you know, the luxury of having in the stream side.
Williams.
And here's T-Rex. We accidentally did a sidestep there when we weren't supposed to. We were supposed to be just doing the, like, forward one.
Thurston. Tompkins. Ball and all tackle.
So we couldn't get another pass away there. So going to run it. Oh, look at this. Absolutely superb. Oh, and they made the tackle. No freaking way. Goulding.
Intercept.
Oh, then Morris intercept. That's another intercept. Wasn't even trying to intercept that time. I was just trying to race up for a tackle, try and get a quick tackle in. Oh, so it looks like we're going to win this one. But like I said, like, leave in the comments your thoughts on Super League. It'd also be good to see an English person's, or like a regular watcher's, opinion of the Super League compared to NRL. Like, is there that much of a difference? Is it? I think I was explaining before they really scored a try that it's more like the top sides, like the, you know, the sorry, I can't pronounce the words. The Wigan and the Leeds and all that, they're fine. They could compete in the NRL, but it's the lower ones. Just suppose, you know, it's pretty good. But like, where would the Sharks have finished? I'm sure they probably wouldn't have finished very high.
On the match, Gus.
Yeah. I suppose that's always a thing. You always go, well, if you throw a worse side into the Super League, they still come, like, top four. Probably not. Not really. So, looks like Sonny Bill picked up man of the match. Brett Morris, 2 tries. It's another win. I'm not sure who we're going to be taking on next. We may take on the State of Origin sides, or might go back to some, like, fantasy sort of sides. Who knows? But I'd like to say thank you for watching. If you can leave a like, that would be awesome. And subscribe to the channel and make sure you leave comments with all the questions I asked. Alright, see you guys. Bye.